these algal blooms are directly related to warmer temperatures. So the sustained warmer temperatures will generate more of these algal blooms, whereas they may not have been as common in the past. Cyanobacteria, or these algal blooms, as they're called, change the water to a blue-green or even like a pea soup green color and consistency. Since there are a lot of these blooms that are not toxic, there's no way to visually determine the difference between a toxic or a non-toxic one. But the most important thing would be if you see this discolored water and the foam on top of the water, just keep your dog away. The symptoms can vary depending on which type of toxin they're exposed to. If it's the hepatotoxin or the liver toxin, they can develop some vomiting, some diarrhea. Owners may notice bloody or even black and tarry stool. As the toxin progresses in the body and the liver begins to fail, they can show signs of weakness, collapse, shock, and eventually death. With the neurotoxin, the signs are related directly related to the nervous system. They'll notice excessive drooling, excessive tearing of the eyes. Then they'll see that they develop some difficulty breathing. Their gums and their mucous membranes will turn a bluish color, and then ultimately they'll die from respiratory distress and paralysis. If they think that there's any chance that they've been exposed and that they're showing any of these signs or symptoms, immediate veterinary care is imperative to have a chance of supporting them and getting them through this. There's no specific antidote for these toxins, but what we do is we treat the body systems that are being affected and try and support them through it, whether it's the liver or the respiratory system. We just let the body kind of process the toxins themselves and basically support them through it. Toxicity occurs after ingestion. And so if they're on a boat or walking near the lake, even if there's an algal bloom, even if there's some toxins being produced, that shouldn't cause a problem. It's not through aerosolization, so if they breathe it in, that's not causing the problem. However, as these algal blooms develop, they actually kind of form this foam on the tops of the water because the bacteria float. So if there is some wind and it blows the foam towards the edge of the water or even onto the land, the curious dog can go up and lick that foam and you would have the same toxicity.